The fact that you can rent a U-Haul van at 18, but not a car until you're 25 in most places, is a fact that I've known, but I never thought I would have to use, I guess until I did. Rainbow Lakes Campground, according to the U.S. Department of Agriculture, is located near Nederland, Colorado, at an elevation of 10,000 feet, and it boasts no drinking water, electricity, phone service, camper hookups, dump stations, or showers. And it is also the proud owner of the roughest road I have ever had the pleasure of maneuvering, and a pain in a half to bring a U-Haul cargo van up. So just last summer, I spent a week and a half up there, practically alone with two girls who I did just meet 2 months before, living out of said U-Haul van in the height of the August heat. But to this day, I would say it is, if not one of the most rewarding things that I have ever done. We were restless and finding the inevitable end of summer, and that's how this idea was hatched. We'd all spent the summer working and uncertain of what the fall would look like for one reason or another, whether that be moving into college or onto the next job. Where we were at the time was by no means any of our dream lives, but it was certain, it was steady, and it was safe, so we wanted to cling to it. We knew exactly what was expected of us when the sun rose in the morning every day and set at night. So, because of this, when August began to draw to a close, instead of leaning into that change for a new experience, packing up and leaving our lives behind, we jumped on impulse and rented a 9-foot van none of us had any business driving and jumped on the adventure for a week of camping. Camping. Technically, it was just camping. I think it's funny that that's still how I would describe it. That week, when more or less it was probably more like a end of the world survivalist training boot camp, if you want to get real dramatic. We were all broke beyond belief, so the food run we made at the beginning consisted of a 5-bag pound of rice, a seasoning turntable, and literal raw potatoes, because we thought that would be enough to sustain us for a week and a half. All of which ended up tasting like smoke and ash only, because little did we know that tinfoil on top of a camping grill grate is not usually a recipe for success. I went to sleep sweating and woke up freezing on the metal floor of the van. I was miserable and tired and so sore all the time, and I would do it all again in a heartbeat. Because yes, I was cold and uncomfortable when I fell asleep, but I fell asleep giggling and sharing the experience with two people I didn't know if I would ever see again after the week was up. The food always sucked, but without a doubt, every night the man who ran the campsite with his dog would come down in their beat-up golf cart, ask to sit and share our meal, and try to assure us that really it wasn't so bad. He had eaten and seen way worse. We cheered when we caught crawdads in the creek and cried when we all ended up with poison ivy. We rinsed off in creeks and streams. We ran across on hikes and drove around to find service every couple of days to make phone calls home. We watched each other take turns cussing out firewood when it would refuse to light, and laughed so hard we cried when we realized that if you give a chipmunk a peanut, he's gonna bring all of his friends back in full force to absolutely ransack anything they can. For as horrible as everything went wrong, something else went miraculously right. And as cheesy as it sounds, everything we did somehow, some way, did always work out. I think that's why, for how awful most of it was, I find myself living in those memories quite often, and reminding myself that things could be much, much worse. From the moment I graduated in May of 2022, all I could think about was everything that could possibly go wrong when I eventually moved in for my first semester of college. A great way to describe what I was caught up in thinking was Murphy's Law. The Cambridge Dictionary defines it as the principle that anything that can go wrong will go wrong. And I think that hits what I was concerned about pretty squarely on the nose. I spent all this time worried that I would get out there and then run into a situation after situation until there was nothing I could do to fix it. And then it did happen. When I say nothing went right about my Colorado trip, I mean literally nothing. And absolutely nothing I was prepared for to go wrong did. Yet somehow nothing was ever too bad or messed up or hard to fix. I just remember kicking myself for worrying about so much and having to consume so much of me leading up to that for all of it to have no purpose. I mean, how could I have ever known that I would lock the keys inside a van I didn't own in the middle of absolutely nowhere, Colorado, and have to figure it out by myself? I couldn't possibly. So when it did happen, I had no other choice but to figure it out by myself. For everything that went wrong that week, we figured it out. Nothing ever came up that we couldn't find some way to deal with, and that was comforting. I don't want to say I emerged from that experience a new person and ready to take on challenges, because that just wouldn't be true. I'm still a nervous train wreck who loves to worry about things out of my control, but I do think I emerged with a sense of confidence. I mean, if I could figure out a situation involving a bear clawing on a rented van that we did not own, because we had neglected to put away our food properly the night before because we had fallen asleep, I was pretty sure that even moving across the country away from everything and everyone